It's basically degeneration of my spine.
Right.
The lower back, I've got two herniated discs.
Right.
And it's practically bone on bone.
Right.
And then in my neck, I've got the narrowing of the column, and that is starting to press on the nerves.
Right.
Surgeons just want to operate, and I don't want to go there because they say if that progresses, I could lose the use of my arms and total use of my legs.
Right, okay.
But my legs swell a lot because I also have a bit of heart failure.
All right, okay. Right. Okay. So, working life, what is it you've done that's put so much strain on your back?
I've always been very active. I started off as an electrical engineer, and I've worked through my life, and I've been senior managers, general managers, CEOs.
Yeah.
And I've always been very, very, very physical and very active.
Yeah.
But in the last, I'd say, 5 to 7 years, it's just totally impossible because I've got pain 24/7.
Right, okay. The reason I'm asking about that is it possible that in your life's journey you've made a rod for your own back?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah? That's when we set our standards right up here, and no matter what, we strive, and we're still, you know, with your health as it is, you're still going to be striving to do the best you possibly can.
That's right.
All right. So we've got to stop that behaviour. Right, so that's easier said than done, isn't it? So just let me, looking for some inspiration now from Spirit World about how we cause that. And I'm going to use this one. Let's see how this goes. All right, so as we go through life, there's a task to be done, and you'll relate to this in the business world. If there's a task to be done in the business world, we adopt a certain persona, a certain mask to get that job done. And with one group of people, it could be, oh, come on, everybody, like a mother hen, getting everybody working together. With another one, it's like, you will do this or you'll be sacked. And so we adopt temporarily a persona to get the job done, yeah? And we're all doing that in our lives. You know, you've got a persona with your mum, a persona with a child, a persona with a partner. And you're not the persona, that's just the mask you wear to get the job done. But a feature of your life has been striving, yeah, okay. So we're not the mask that we wear. Now, those masks, however fabulous those masks look, they take a certain amount of sustaining, and that's where the struggle is in your life, yeah? Because having created the persona, the person that's always calm and peaceful, you try and sustain that, yeah? So your struggle comes often from sustaining one of your masks, yeah? And the real you is not a mask. The real you doesn't take any sustaining, doesn't take any struggle. So think about the different masks that you wear, and from this point on, you're still going to continue to create masks, personas that you play out in your life. But where life gets painful is where we are so identified with one of those masks, one of those personas, that we think we are that, and we try and defend it at all costs. And of course, what's happened for you is you've not been able to do that now because the physical body has let you down. But I bet your life has got richer through this.
Yeah.
So often what we think is a misfortune, it's not. Because otherwise you'd still be striving, wouldn't you? You'd still be burning the midnight oil still. And it's really made you evaluate what is really, really important. And what is really, really important, guys, is our health. If we don't have our health, we've got nothing. You can't even be in a relationship well because you're hurt like hell and you can't do the things you want to do. So health has got to be a priority. And a lot of people spend their health making dollars and then spend their dollars trying to get their health back. Yeah? Right. Now, okay. And Spirit Doctor that's working on you is called Dr. Oswaldo Cruz, and he says you've been on one hell of a journey. Yeah, you look at your life, you've been on one hell of a journey because you don't do things by halves. Yeah, either going to do it all or nothing. Yeah? You don't like compromising. No. And this is the thing, if you were to think about this, guys, we're coming up to the end of the year, aren't we? So this is a time where traditionally what I do is I'd look at the year that's just gone, and I'd look and say, if all my years look like this one, am I closer to my dreams or further away? You know, what was good? What was good in the last 12 months? What am I getting right? What am I not getting right? But this is the thing. If you've got a goal in life, 20 years from now, is that still going to be a goal you're proud of? 50 years from now, is it still going to be a goal you're proud of? If your goals want to be something that, you know, 500 years from now, you look back on this lifetime and think, that was a really good goal I had that lifetime. Yeah, so
yeah.
Forget some of these more trivial New Year's resolutions and think about what would be a real goal? Where would I really, really make a difference? And if I was to say that to you now, what would be your goal?
Just my health.
Your health.
Yeah.
To look after your health so that you can be here longer to do more good in the world. Yeah, cool. So we've got to understand things about our health, and to me it's really, really simple. In here, there are thoughts. Those thoughts, as soon as I've thought them, trigger chemicals in my body. What is supposed to happen is I'm supposed to notice how I feel. If I don't like the feeling, the chemistry in my body, I change the thought. Yeah, but if I do like the chemistry in my body, then that thought's a good thought for me. So your feelings are your main guidance system. Your main guidance system, yeah? You don't like feeling powerless or that your body's out of control.
Yeah.
All right, nobody would you? None of us want to feel our bodies are out of control. Now I think of myself as the ruler of a 6,500 trillion citizens. They're the cells in my body. So in here, the consciousness that I am is the ruler of the kingdom. And the ruler can be a kind, benevolent king, queen, or can be an absolute tyrant, making me do things I don't want to do. Yeah? And so you are the ruler of your kingdom. Okay. Now, any sensation for you at the moment in the back? Any warmth, any tingling?
There's some tingling down the legs.
Awesome. Cool. He's working on the lower section first. Right. Dr. Oswaldo Cruz is brilliant. He's brilliant with spines and any form of paraplegia. Now he's indicating I need to work on the neck. God bless. Mm-hmm. Right, so your spine, guys. Your spine. You've got energy centers in your feet, chakras. Earth energy comes up through your feet, travels up the legs to the base chakra, goes up to the sacral center a couple of inches below the belly button, goes to the solar plexus, the heart, the throat, the third eye and the crown. Spiritual energy comes down. These two energies going down and up form a caduceus. And when that's happening, you feel amazing. Okay? But when it's not happening, there isn't enough energy to start feeding all the vital organs. So your heart will improve when the spine is better. Yeah? It's entirely possible for the heart to improve when the flow of energy up and down the spine is better. Right now, the surgeon's got scissors out at the neck. So that's really significant. Not every healing I see the scissors, but when I do see the scissors, it means he's actually making an incision. Any sensation in the top of the neck?
It's sensitive.
Is that again it?
A bit sensitive.
It's a bit sensitive, yeah. Cool. Tom, the lead surgeon, is Dr. Oswaldo Cruz, and the three of them are spread out a little bit and they're extending the auric field. They're using their consciousness to extend the auric field. Now the neck is all about our ability to see things from more than one angle. Einstein said that the highest form of intelligence was the ability to see things from more than one perspective without collapsing either perspective. So the more perspectives we have, the better. You know, if we wanted how this country's resources were managed to be done better, we wouldn't just ask one person, we'd probably consult a number of people that are experts in that field. Okay, now try moving your head again, Tom, see how that's feeling.
No more grinding.
That's good, isn't it?
Absolutely no more grinding.
Yeah. Alright, he's really good, Dr. Oswald. He's really good.
Take him home with me.
It's funny when I go to bed at night, my partner very often I'll just say, Jeanette, is that you? Just to make sure it's not Dr. Oswald in the morning. Right, Tom, are you ready to give this a go and just see how your walking feels?
Yep.
Yep. It does feel better.
Falling over.
Well, that's a good isn't it?
I think that's my biggest fear is falling.
Yes.
And the thing is that the pain goes from the back into the hips and down the legs.
Yeah.
But the improvement is, I can put that one up, and I can put that one up now.
You couldn't do that before?
Well, when
he
was here, he was in.
Hey,
I think we have to do
cooking with gas, aren't we? That was just the first healing sweep, so we're going to do another healing sweep now. These beings are truly, truly amazing, eh?
They are.
Yeah.
I like these guys.
Right. So normally you have to go to Brazil to see these guys, but so you don't really have to sit on a plane for over many hours. Side, one of the other surgeons is very, very happy with the work. And then one of the three has just given the order now to strengthen. They don't strengthen until everything's in the right place. That's also very good. More surgeon scissors this time at the base of the spine. That's a good sign. And they're addressing the pain that travels down the legs. Right, the time for another test drive. How exciting, eh?
Yeah.
Too brave.
So how did that feel then?
Great.
Great. Yeah, you might be onto something then with these surgeons, so time's going to tell. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't overdo it. Will it make any difference? Right, so what sometimes happens is people feel so amazing they go away and overdo it. Like I had a 90-year-old in New Plymouth, kid you not, I worked on her neck and her shoulders, she was brilliant, she felt so good, she went home and stripped every room in the house of wallpaper.
Oh my gosh!
Always muscles again, so, yeah. Yeah, so don't overdo it. So they've done surgery to the top of the neck, and that was really, really very, very careful stuff that they've done. And then they've done a surgery and a strengthening to the lower back. So pain-wise, how are you feeling at the moment?
I don't know. Pain's about, I'd say, 95% at least for what I had.
Yeah, awesome.
Wow.
Yeah. Sitting over there, I kept on having to sit forward and move.
Yeah. Yeah, so they've done what they need to for this session, but we'll let you go away and experience, you know, what more you can do, and we'll stay in touch.
Thank you.
We'll follow up with the group.